The concept of reusability gains significant interest, particularly in relation to a specific aspect that is often overlooked by the majority of individuals, the fairing. Not only did he acknowledge this, but Musk and SpaceX also highlighted astonishing statistics pertaining to this particular component. In today's episode of Science of Space, we will delve into these remarkable details. In 2023, as well as outlining plans for 2024, SpaceX continues to witness the strong development of Starship. However, it is important to note that Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy still play a significant role in SpaceX's system. The launch frequency has experienced a remarkable increase compared to previous years, indicating the company's progress. This can be attributed to the higher number of booster landings and reuses, surpassing a milestone of 280 times. It is crucial to acknowledge that the booster is not the only component that can be reused on Falcon rockets. The fairing, positioned atop the rockets to safeguard the payloads, has also been a focus for SpaceX in terms of recovery. Over time, they have achieved considerable success in this endeavor. Elon Musk, when discussing booster reuse and this year's launch goals, emphasized the importance of fairing recovery. He highlighted that many people are unaware that SpaceX has successfully recovered the fairing, which was indeed a challenging task. An immense amount of effort has been put into the recovery of the fairing, and we are now successfully recovering it on a regular basis. In fact, we have reflowed the fairings more than 300 times. The presentation also highlighted some interesting information, revealing that each recovery of the reflow fairing saves around $6 million. This achievement is no less impressive than the other accomplishments mentioned earlier. It is worth noting that SpaceX has achieved this feat despite the extreme difficulty of recovering the fairing, as acknowledged by Elon Musk himself. The reality is that the fairings remain operational for most of the mission until the payload is released at the planned region. This is in contrast to the booster, which only operates for about 2.5 minutes before separating from the second stage. To illustrate the challenge, let's consider the payload that Falcon 9 frequently launches today, the Starlink satellites. These satellites operate at altitudes exceeding 500 kilometers, making the return from such high altitudes particularly challenging, due to atmospheric resistance. SpaceX made efforts to minimize the influence of external factors on their fairings. Initially, they used parachutes to slow down the falling speed, but faced the challenge of recovering the fairings. To address this, SpaceX employed two ships, Mystery and Mischief, equipped with a net system to catch the fairings upon landing. This approach aimed to prevent the components from being affected by seawater. However, this method proved to be complex and had a low success rate. Fortunately, SpaceX realized that the impact of seawater on the fairings was not as severe as initially thought. As a result, they decided to remove the net systems and instead used ships with mounting cranes to salvage and recover the fairings. This streamlined approach proved to be more efficient and is still being utilized today. The reason SpaceX pays great attention to recovering the fairings is primarily due to the significant cost involved. Each Falcon 9 fairing costs around $6 million, accounting for approximately 10% of the total launch cost. Considering the overall expenses of space missions, where the Falcon 9 launch costs around $67 million, and even more for the Falcon Heavy, the $6 million for fairings may seem relatively insignificant. However, when accumulated over time, this seemingly modest amount becomes astronomically significant. Elon Musk once highlighted the importance of this by stating, "You have $6 million falling from the sky." Therefore, SpaceX's focus on recovering the fairings is driven by the desire to maximize cost efficiency in their launches. Elon Musk mentioned 300 launches in his presentation, costing SpaceX $1.8 billion. This highlights the significant financial implications. With this sum, SpaceX could potentially carry out 900 Falcon 9 missions, or 27 Starship launches. Recovering the fairing is a highly beneficial economic solution for SpaceX. In addition to landing boosters, fairing recovery has aided in reusing workhorse rockets. Falcon rockets continue to dominate space missions, launching 12,200 tons to orbit in 2023, compared to less than 400 tons by the rest of the world. This makes Falcon rockets more comprehensive than any other rocket system. The recovery of 300 fairings marks a potential revolution in the aerospace industry. The concept of reusability has been a long-standing problem in the majority of organizations, including NASA, the world's largest national aerospace organization. Currently, NASA is working on the SLS rocket for the Artemis lunar mission. While the SLS completed its maiden flight in 2022, which was a noteworthy achievement, it suffers from a significant drawback: it lacks reusability, including the fairing. This limitation contributes to the exorbitant launch cost of the SLS, exceeding $2 billion. According to a report by NASA's Office of Inspector General, when factoring in various other expenses, this cost can escalate to over $4 billion. Undeniably, NASA's investment in the SLS is immense. As a government entity, NASA operates with some financial alleviation. However, private companies like SpaceX face a different reality. While they pursue the mission of advancing rocket launches for humanity, they must also engage in profitable ventures to sustain their operations. Effective financial control becomes pivotal for survival, as inadequate management could lead to collapse and bankruptcy. Therefore, cost reduction becomes a critical determinant for the success of any company. In the case of SpaceX, their strategy revolves around reuse. With over 260 successfully landed boosters, they have already saved substantial amounts. The recent addition of fairing recovery further contributes to potential savings amounting to billions. This figure is projected to climb rapidly, with the increasing frequency of Falcon 9 launches, solidifying the foundation of SpaceX's success. A combination of reusing resources and optimizing costs is the driving force behind SpaceX's strategy. Their Starship, the largest rocket in the world, aims to achieve full reusability, marking a significant milestone in the history of space exploration. This ambitious endeavor showcases SpaceX's unwavering commitment to innovation and sustainability in the aerospace industry. While there is still much work to be done, SpaceX has rightfully earned the title of a pioneering organization in reusability. Their genius economic solutions, such as landing boosters and fairing recovery, serve as valuable lessons for all aerospace organizations worldwide. As the aerospace industry continues to gain popularity, the quest for space exploration and the discovery of new realms will require substantial capital. The company that can effectively reduce costs will emerge as the winner in this race. Therefore, reusability will remain a prominent trend in the aerospace industry, and SpaceX will undoubtedly continue to lead the way in this effort. They will persist in creating remarkable achievements, aligning with Musk's belief that reusability is the key to a prosperous future in space. We hope you enjoyed today's episode and gained new insights. We would love to hear your thoughts on the significance of reusability in the broader context of space exploration. That's it for today's episode. We hope you enjoyed it and learned something new. Please let us know what you think in the comments section down below. Your feedback is very important to us, because it helps us make better videos for you. So thank you very much, and we hope to see you again next time.